The following program is a presentation of the Matt Wrestling Network. Viewer discretion is advised. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Battlegrounds. Coming up tonight, we've got 9 crazy matches for you, including a main event for the ages. The current Battlegrounds World Champion Edge, who won that title defeating Stone Cold Steve Austin in a tournament final, is facing off in a rematch against Austin, this time a non-title affair. But that's going to headline the card tonight. We're going to start things off, though, with Daniel Bryan taking on Dolph Ziggler. Daniel Bryan and Kofi Kingston faced off against Dolph Ziggler and Robert Roode a couple of weeks ago. Last week, Daniel Bryan took on Robert Roode. Kofi Kingston faced off against Dolph Ziggler tonight, switching dance partners, so to speak. As I continue to await my shipping information to be updated for the fucking PS5. It's incredibly frustrating. Skipping the entrance in as we usually do. Right away, Dolph Ziggler sliding to the outside to grab that mallet. With the fists of fury. Had to adjust some of the audio settings recently, so hopefully it sounds okay with this game, too. I'm gonna have to check it out. Oh, Ziggler blocks in the Irish whip into the corner. Going back to that mallet. Can't block that. So squeaky.
Set for the ride. Final destination. The apron.
Oh no, how do you block that? Ziggler blocking everything. Can't block that. Bryan literally on fire. Tossing Ziggler high into the air and the double uppercuts of death. By God. That's got to get at least a one count.
Goes for the cover.
We have to check on the audio. Everything's down okay over the game, Nadia. Oh no. Can you hear me okay?
Incoming beauty! Whoa! Nice!
And the big elbow. Ziggler's going to town on Bryan. What's he gonna do here? Oh, a foolish mistake. Ziggler fucked up.
Going to the heights.
Oh God. Bryan fucked up too. It's a war of attrition in this opening contest on the Battlegrounds.
What's he got in mind here? Oh, this is begun. Oh, it is great.
The vertical suplex. Suck it, Ziggler, you lost to a vertical suplex, you're a bitch. It's not 1979 anymore. Who does that? Who loses to a vertical suplex? You're fired. No, not really. Our roster's way too small for that. Leveled up, finally got a little bit of currency, and I do mean a little bit, because it's not even enough to buy a damn character. Not even enough to buy the cheapest level of character. we could see the tag team partners of those two men square off against each other as Kofi Kingston takes on Robert Roode. Roode's gotta hope he fares better than his partner, losing to a vertical suplex. Can't be hard to top that. Lagging in the menu. Went past it. Gotta love how Walmart keeps sending me all these spam emails. Well, not spam, I guess, but marketing emails. Yet they can't send me an update on my Xbox or PlayStation. I'm in PlayStation. Jesus Christ, I'm sleep deprived. I got my Xbox 4 days early, so maybe they're gonna try to punish me by sending me on PlayStation 4 days late. There's the trash talking they're known for. Oh, this should be good. Oh no, not the verticals. Oh, it's a jackhammer.
I can't believe it!
Robert Roode doesn't do a jackhammer. Excited about that main event tonight. Of course, gonna have Kofi's New Day brother Xavier Woods in action later tonight, taking on Shinsuke Nakamura. Xavier and Big E, of course, the tag team champions of the Battlegrounds. Kofi Kingston pursuing solo success. Win over the likes of Robert Roode tonight would go a long way in propelling him further up the card. Of course, we know Kofi's capable of becoming a champion wherever he's at, wherever he works. Oh.
It's over. It could have been over.
Let me know in the chat if you have any plans of getting a PS5 or an Xbox Series X soon, or if you already got an Xbox Series X, I should say. Oh, what a big kick to the head. I'm loving the Series X so far. Those load times and I only had the PS4 and Xbox One, the original versions of each. So I never had a console that can display 4K graphics. Like, I've got a PC that can do it, but my monitor only does 1440p. Haven't really tried hooking it up to my TV. I know it can display on there. I'm just not sure how well the experience would translate. Regardless, seeing stuff like Gears 5 and Forza Horizon 4 4K Gears is at 120 frames a second. It's just insane. The ray tracing too, it's just, for somebody who's exclusively played on consoles up until less than 3 months ago when I got my first ever gaming PC, it's just a ridiculous, crazy, amazing thing that I'm loving it.
Let the mind games begin.
Aru fucking up opposing. Oh, there it is. The vertical suplex. That's gotta do it. Only a one count. How? That was a vertical fucking suplex. That put away Dolph Ziggler.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, it looks like yes.
Roode up top. Turnbuckle's glowing. Is the ring about to break? I thought only when the ring broke is when you could actually utilize the turnbuckles as a weapon.
Oh.
Flaming foot dropkick, but that's not enough as Roode is whipped into the ropes and. Oh no. Roode caught Kingston. Sit out powerbomb. Now slugging it out. Get out of here, you son of a bitch. Countering everything. Strikes, grapples. Oh no. Seemed like Moro tripped over himself trying to explain that.
Trouble's starting. You mean Trouble in Paradise? How the fuck? I didn't know. I've never seen anybody counter that particular move before.
Speedy recovery. You're feeling fine now.
Yeah, don't mind if I do. Can't escape two vertical suplexes.
Looking to pin him. One.
He's superhuman.
Boy, he did that to perfection.
Not the YouTube stunt man, but literally superhuman. Oh, the boom drop. The boom drop. Robert Roode. How the fuck did he get right back up? I didn't even have a chance to cover him. He just no-sold that completely. What an ass. Robert Roode, who would have ever thought that he was going to put up such a fight?
This should be good. Oh, yes, it's definitely good. Oh, I've never seen anything like that.
Oh, here it goes. No.
Doing a great job of defending.
Roode ducked out of the way, but unable to capitalize on the opportunity. Oh, no. I spoke too soon.
Whoa, are you kidding me?
Ah, the double stop. Cosplaying as Finn Balor. Oh, just moved out of the way in time. How embarrassing would that have been for him to lose after missing a double stomp? All the way on the opposite side of the ring. How would he still hit it? With the glorious pose, he's wasting time. No, he countered again into the face buster. Robert Roode may win this match. Oh no, Robert Roode just beat Kofi Kingston. Big win for Roode. And we get to hear that classic theme song. Moving on to women's action next with Brie Bella taking on Stephanie McMahon. I'm going to get my actual microphone. I'm going to check the audio levels once again. I can get this to work, right? Testing, testing, testing. So if I'm a little bit louder, it works. Alright, I'll just do that. Ah, crap. Brie Bella and Stephanie McMahon. First women's match of three tonight. We saw Stephanie McMahon debut last week with victory over Liv Morgan. Will she be successful against Brie Bella, the former Divas Champion, tonight? Every time I get a notification, I think it's... I hope, I guess, not think it's going to be the PS5. But nothing yet. It's supposed to be delivered tomorrow, according to Walmart's website, but who knows.
Making her way to the ring.
3, 2, 1. Not done dishing out the punishment.
Uh-oh. Brie Bella landed in early. Maybe wants revenge for SummerSlam 2014. The final SummerSlam in Los Angeles of 6 in a row. Those were good days, man. Being able to go to SummerSlam every year. But after that long feud, Nikki turned on Brie and helped Stephanie beat her. And then Brie just became Nikki's, for lack of a better term, bitch. And then suddenly they were friends again one day. It's like, okay. Went from saying, I wish you died in the womb, to, hey, we're sisters. We love each other. Going for the chair. That was a mistake. Oh no, no. Pink explosion. One of Dolph Ziggler's trademarks. That's not a joke or anything. He just uses that move a lot in this game. DDT. Oh, the DDT. Stephanie, I've never seen her do a DDT. Only in one count, maybe she should have practiced more. There you go, jackhammer. Stephanie McMahon is the Goldberg of the women's division. Is she going to continue her streak to 2-0? Only in one count again. Oh, and Brie Bella with that reverse Rana. Back up to the top, and oh, a double axe handle. She's Brie Bella just can't stop going up to the top. Oh, the face buster, the Brie mode face buster. Is that gonna put away Steph? Not going even for a cover even after that. It's her best move. Oh, Brie's in trouble now. She's going to regret not going for the cover earlier. Just laying in stiff kicks to the ribs. And oh, Brie is getting destroyed right now. Oh, no. Oh, my God. The pedigree. It's all over. It's all over. You don't kick out of that. Are we gonna be able to kick out? No! That's it! It's a winner! Impressive win for Stephanie McMahon, 2-0 in the women's division on the Battlegrounds. Look at that girl there, hips, lips, hair. Something, something, something that won't compare. Nobody do her like she do her. Those are all the words I know. Man, I don't know what's going on in the Stephanie McMahon still celebrating in the ring. All this pyro is going to cost a lot of money. Going back to men's action though, for our next contest, we've got Drew McIntyre taking on the Big Show. It's like I'm big and I'm Scottish, and I like kicking people in the face. That was a terrible impersonation. I can't do it right now. Fuck it. Charlotte Flair, who you see on the screen right now, will be in action a little later on, taking on Naomi. Well, it's the Big Show. Yes, it is indeed the big bad show tonight. I still don't know why the load times are so lengthy on this game when it's not very detailed, but hey, what are you gonna do? Maybe the PS5 will prove that if it ever gets here. A match that took place right after Drew McIntyre won his WWE Championship at WrestleMania earlier this year. Aired as the main event of Raw the following night, Drew McIntyre and the Big Show. Big Show turned heel for that match and came back to face, because who the fuck even knows what he's doing anymore? Big Show has turned heel and face about 48 times in his career, and I mean that quite literally. Handling Drew McIntyre right now, though. Oh, I pressed X and it didn't work as a reversal. Way to screw me over, game. Got another awesome night of action tomorrow night. Fire Pro Wrestling MWF Matitude. I'll be joined by Chris Coron and Red Jed. Simulating Fire Pro matches and doing commentary. We're going to have lots of crazy characters from celebrities, fictional characters, and a few real wrestlers all in action. Always some wild stuff going on. Going to be determining a number one contender for the International Championship. Currently held by Thanos. We're going to see four competitors in an elimination match try to determine who's going to face off with them in our next pay-per-view Christmas. Oh, wait. Not Christmas Chaos. I fucked that up. I need to really practice playing and talking at the same time because I've screwing up both of them. We do have one more pay-per-view before Christmas Chaos, of course. One coming at the end of November. Oh, damn. Oh, Drew McIntyre, the future shock. Dropping Big Show on his head from 10 feet in the air. Only a one count. Well, it is the Big Show. As the song says. Gotta recharge some health. Big Show laid it in those hard strikes earlier. Took its toll on Drew McIntyre. But Drew looking strong at the current time. Just beating the fuck out of the Big Show. Oh, he's got the unblockable ability. No! Escape. Run away, Drew. Oh, a big power slam and an elbow drop right after.
Uh-oh, what's happening here, Moro?
Oh, he's looking to take a respite on the outside, King.
I don't blame him.
Come on. There we go. That'll even the odds a little bit. Oh, Big Show into the ring post. What's McIntyre got in store for Show out here? Oh, right on the face. Gotta get back into the ring though to finish this off.
Minding their P's and Q's, King.
And there it is! The Claymore! Drew McIntyre nails that Claymore on the Big Show. And it is all over.
Here we go. Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner, yeah. Or Ronaldo, he just sat in a booth and recorded himself saying, shouting cliches for 3 hours, and that was the extent of his work on the game. Earning currency at a snail's pace. It's wonderful. Alright, coming up next, Xavier Woods taking on Shinsuke Nakamura. Xavier Woods, one half of the Battlegrounds Tag Team Champions. Shinsuke Nakamura and Cesaro challenged for those titles, but they got themselves disqualified inadvertently. Oh, back. Looking to procure those belts. First, they gotta earn another title shot. Arguing the referee did them a disservice by disqualifying them, that they didn't break any rules.
coming up later on tonight. Naomi's and Charlotte Flair in our next match. We got Rey Mysterio and Ricochet against Sho Kozuna with disqualifications turned off for that one, since the first two matches between those teams ended with disqualification for the illegal man spending too much time in the ring. Sasha Banks taking on Nikki Cross, and of course our main event, Edge versus Stone Cold Steve Austin, non-title contest rematch of the World Championship Tournament Final on our very first episode. Stone Cold had a chance to become number one contender a couple weeks ago at Gold Rush. Took on John Cena that night, but fell a little bit short. John Cena in his debut, able to defeat Stone Cold Steve Austin, and Cena will go on to our second Gold Rush event at the end of this month, and will battle Edge for the World Championship, assuming Edge still holds that title once we get there. As at this point, he's not scheduled to make any title defenses, but things could change at a moment's notice. You never know in Battlegrounds. Xavier Woods refusing to get tossed to the outside. I just noticed that they gave him the pointy boots in this game too. Pretty sure he doesn't use those anymore, but gotta admit I haven't watched a lot of the weekly TV recently. Oh, Shinsuke Nakamura paying tribute to his favorite American, John Cena. Attitude adjustment about getting kicked in the face. The explosion of pink. Oh no! What the fuck? Shinsuke Nakamura just dove out to the floor and committed seppuku. Perhaps it was all just a trap to lure Xavier out here. Oh, the reverse power slam. The cross arm breaker, it's a submission hold, but not really in this game.
Hey, wonder what's under that ring.
Oh, but Woods getting whipped with that chair. Nakamura is on fire right now. Nakamura says two in the pink, one in the stink. Don't mind if I do. Oh god! The big elbow. It's like his rope walk elbow. The vertical suplex, we know that could finish any man on any given day. I regret my choice of words immediately. What's gonna happen here? Oh, the double axe handle. Oh my god. The double axe handle. We've had a vertical suplex finish a match and now a double axe handle. What year is it? Load screen stops to go to another load screen. You gotta love it. Switching back to women's action for Naomi and Charlotte Flair. And another load screen. Shit. At least with the PS5, maybe they'll be shorter. That one was pretty short, but some of them are not. Pre-match load screens, not so much. Do you feel the glow?
Bring it to the flow.
Becky Lynch there we haven't seen in Battlegrounds. I gotta wonder if she's gonna be making an appearance anytime soon. Maybe if they give you currency at a faster rate. Hey MVG, what's going on, man? How you doing tonight?
Making her way to the ring.
Three, two,
just getting ready to start Charlotte Flair and Naomi. We're about halfway through the show tonight, a little more than halfway, I guess. Oh, Naomi just about got dropped on her head with that exploder. Oh. Left hands. Charlotte with that big power advantage, hammering away at the midsection, and now the jaw of Naomi sending her twirling back down to the mat in pain. Oh, don't tell me she's going to do it again. Nice reversal into a German suplex to Naomi. Thought she was going to head up top, but lifting Charlotte to her feet. Oh, nice. Well, thank you for taking the time to tune in. Now that you're home, hopefully you've been having a good day. Sorry, I'm not very good at talking and playing at the same time quite yet. Oh, roundhouse kick to the face and then natural selection. Naomi's not done yet. Only a one count.
Oh, what a combination! What the heck was that?
I saw that you were streaming earlier this afternoon, but wasn't at home, so I wasn't able to tune in. My mobile data's not fast enough to watch Twitch, unfortunately. I tried it before. Yeah, I saw the teaser. It looks really good, actually. Obviously, the gameplay is going to be what determines how good it is, but everything that I saw looked promising. What'd you think about it? Can not block moves anymore? That's weird.
She hoists him up and boy, she sends him flying. This should be good. Look out. Whoa! I can't believe it!
Oh yeah, I'm gonna be getting that too. I'm pretty sure that the casino game's free. Aw, crap. I'm sure it's like free to play and that you can still buy stuff, but it's free to download. Oh, she's countering everything. I'm actually most excited about the general manager game because it sounds kind of like Total Extreme Wrestling. Oh, that's the second one. That's got to put her away. Finally, Charlotte puts Naomi away. Alright. Now we get to see Rey Mysterio and Ricochet taking on Shoko Zuna once again, this time. Gonna make sure that disqualifications for the illegal person spending too much time in the ring are turned off, so that we're gonna get a definitive winner in this match. Finally, third time around.
Changing the match rules. Much better. We've already seen Big Show in action once tonight. It's going to be the first time outside of a tournament that we've had a wrestler work multiple matches in the same night. Big Show was already scheduled for a match with Drew McIntyre this week. But due to the controversial nature of the way matches ended between Big Show and Yokozuna and Ricochet and Rey Mysterio the last couple times out, Big Show was willing to do anything it took to get this rematch. It was either have it tonight or don't have it at all. Hopefully Big Show isn't still suffering the effects of that claymore. It's only been maybe 15 minutes since he got kicked in the face. Now he's going out here in tag team action. Big Show, I think Rey Mysterio and Ricochet combined don't even weigh as much as one of these guys. So they're severely outmatched in the size department. But Rey Mysterio and Ricochet bring a lot of talent, a lot of abilities in other areas. Both have been incredibly successful in their careers. We'll see what happens tonight. Certainly not the first time Mysterio and Big Show have faced off in their careers. Rey Mysterio missing that dropkick attempt early on, and Big Show currently making him pay for it. Dropping him face first to the mat. Just lifting him up, just palming his head like a basketball. And as we all know, thanks to Batista, basketballs don't hold grudges, but Rey Mysterio will hold a grudge. Oh, nice counter into kind of a crossbody, kind of a spear. Oh shit. Ricochet wants a tag, but Mysterio not ready to get out of the ring quite yet. And here comes Ricochet. Show just caved in his chest with that chop. Lifting him back to his feet and the choke slam. Big Show with red eyes. My God. The fury of Satan in his soul. Rey Mysterio with a donkey punch to save his partner, but it. Oh, God. Big Show going for a spear, but Ricochet just countering with that springboard. The unblockable springboard that I hate. Oh, he hit it. I didn't think I was going to connect, but Big Show with the big spear. And not even a one count, but Yokozuna just bodied Rey Mysterio.
Springboard, and boy, did he get some serious airtime. Little bad things can happen up there.
Take that.
Turns the tables.
Oh, no way. Come on, Ricochet could not lift Yokozuna. There's no way in hell. Oh, that's a mistake.
Not going for that.
No more springboards.
Hey, block. What are you gonna do now?
Oh, what? As far as I know, there's literally no way to block a springboard. Oh, no. The 450. Come on. Oh, a jackhammer from Yokozuna. Yoko's got to be worn down, though. Oh, it's chaos erupting inside the ring. Normally, this would end in a disqualification right now, but that's why we turned it off. Yokozuna's so damn slow. Thanks for the chair, Ricochet.
Here we go. Oh, look out. Ah!
I was trying to pick up the chair and not go outside the ring. Oh no, it knocked off both our partners. Shit. Oh, you're getting so casual about that punch. Rey Mysterio making the save. Big Show needs to take him out. Come on. Why is Big Show not helping?
Yeah, he's ascending the turnbuckle.
Oh boy. I'm gonna hit Big Show instead.
Well, I think he's having second thoughts. He's leaving the ring. Turns the table.
Oh, come on.
Counter.
Countering everything.
What's he gonna do? What? Oh, wow.
And we went after Show instead. Oh, he's gonna pay. That leg drop put away Hogan and Ricochet no sells it. Are you kidding me?
Here we go. Oh, the Irish whip. You're not gonna beat anybody with that. Here we go.
The jackhammer's gotta do it.
Oh, does that make you dizzy? Steady stream of
Big Show just doesn't do anything.
Going for the cover.
I don't even care that I accidentally hit him. Nope, didn't get my PS5 yet. I'm still waiting on the notification for it to hopefully say it's going to be delivered tomorrow.
What's going to happen here?
So,
it's not going to be good!
It was only the day before I got my Xbox that they finally sent me a text that FedEx did. Said it was on its way. So, at this point I'm not really optimistic, but there's still a chance, I guess. All four men brawling in the ring now. It's Big Show lays into Mysterio. And Ricochet. Mysterio knock off the apron. He's got to make that save. Oh, man. Ricochet was done. Why is Yokozuna keeps punching Big Show, his own tag team partner. Big Show's second match of the night. He's gotta be exhausted. Oh no. Ricochet makes a tag. And the game just about crashed, I think. Yokozuna with the slowest run ever. These guys not getting disqualified from the illegal man in the ring. It's been a really entertaining match. Mysterio with another springboard. Oh, the lion salt. The acai moonsault. Oh no, Yokozuna took out Ricochet, but not Mysterio. There it is. A giant jumping choke slam. Big Show and Yokozuna. Ricochet doesn't even want to bother. They've done it. Shokozuna. And Yoko's getting down. After two disqualification losses, Yokozuna and the Big Show had defeated Rey Mysterio and Ricochet. Big Show winning the match after being knocked out earlier by Drew McIntyre's Claymore. Coming back and getting a big tag team win. So all credit to him for that. And they're still fighting outside the ring, it looks like. I can barely see it out of the side. Be nice to know what was going on. Only two matches left to go. I don't know what he's doing, but oh well. Just kicking and swinging. Sasha Banks in her first singles match in the Battleground, taking on Nikki Cross. Huge women's matchup coming up next, and then our main event that I've mentioned several times throughout the broadcast, the world champion Edge taking on Stone Cold Steve Austin in a non-title affair.
At least we haven't been dropping any frames tonight. I don't know what the deal was last night. Well, the later it gets, the less I think I'm actually going to get any sort of notification. I guess technically they could deliver it without notifying me ahead of time, but
they get her way to the ring.
Not counting on it.
One.
I was hoping that this was going to be the last ever stream on the PS4. I was going to be able to use PS5 tomorrow night, but I guess we'll find out. So this may or may not be it. If they deliver it on time, then I'll have it set up, ready to go tomorrow. Nikki Cross whipping a series of motorcycles out her pants. That's pretty hot, you know. Oh my god. After seeing some footage of NBA 2K21 running in 4K on the Xbox Series X, really want to try that out. It's just crazy how realistic it looks just for the first iteration of the game on a new generation. Oh, I don't know what Sasha was going for there, but it did not work out at all.
Oh, what a combination.
Nikki Cross making her pay for her error. Oh, what? I'm not sure if Sasha whipped down a motorcycle or if Nikki was going for it again and just got smashed. Oh, the RKO! Hurricane Rana from Sasha headed up top. Just waiting for Nikki Cross to stand back up and a big spinning punch. Not even a one count. Nikki ran in, turns the suplex into a German suplex for him. Yeah, PS5 is backward compatible with all, but there's only like 10 games, I think, that they've listed that aren't backwards compatible with for a PS4, from PS4 to PS5.
Sasha Banks went bankrupt.
Bankrupt, the neck breaker. Taking Cross out, going for the cover.
Close for the cover.
Only a one count off that, come on. Blocking those shots from Cross. Hurricane Rana again, but only a one count. Nikki Cross is resilient, if nothing else. Oh no. Now Nikki with a
neck breaker.
As Moro said, the fisherman's neck breaker, but not going for a cover. Gotta question the logic. Fine. Let's recover our health and beat it out of each other.
Oh,
the motorcycles, the chairs. Heading up top again, can she make it all the way over there? Oh god! No! Sasha misses! Oh, and barely, that's like the first time I successfully kicked out of anything in this game. It just seems to freeze whenever it gets to the top. Any other time. Another vertical suplex. There's no way she can withstand all that. Wow. Nikki Cross is invincible.
Incoming beauty. Whoa, nice.
Going for it again. And oh, she misses the shooting star one more time. Barely escaping that Boston Crab. Sasha keeps going for it. Oh, this time I missed it worse than ever before. That's gotta do it. A second bankrupt.
Dominating. Oh, wow. Going for the cover.
Sasha Banks victorious in her singles debut. It's time for the main event of the evening. World Champion Edge versus Stone Cold Steve Austin. One on one. Oh no, it's still in women's match mode. Alright, well yeah. Still the same thing. Just gotta switch categories. That's like the one biggest flaw with this game, in my opinion, is having to switch categories to do women's and men's matches. Like, why can't we just... I mean, on 2K19, I haven't played 2K20, so 2K19, just, you pick the first competitor, and then whatever gender that competitor is, you're only allowed to choose the same gender for their opponent. If WWE doesn't want to have intergender matches in their game, it's very easy to implement that. They've done it before. So, yeah, it is what it is. Oh crap, I forgot. Even though it goes in alphabetical order, for some reason Austin's at the top. Ready to get started. If Austin could pick up a victory against the world champion in this non-title match, you gotta believe that's gonna earn him another opportunity to get a shot at the gold. John Cena's next in line, but if Austin can win this match, he'll face the winner of Edge versus John Cena, at least in my book. And we're underway. Two of the all-time greats. And Stone Cold off to a hot start, just bodying Edge. Running shoulder block, but Edge firing right back, grabbing the arm and face planting him right there in the corner.
Well, look at this. They're seeing stars already, but I think they're about to see more.
A lot at stake here. You know, it's a non-title match. Edge can't afford to lose to Stone Cold. He's already got his hands full of Cena. There it is again. Edge not wanting to leave anything to chance. He needs to stay on Austin. Just be relentless. Oh, badly missing that. Not allowing Austin to get the weapon. He's got an angry rattlesnake to deal with. Oh, and Austin saw it coming that time around and reversed it to a variation of the back body drop. Knocking Austin down. Is it going to give him enough time to get that weapon? The mallet. Oh, breaks after only two strikes. Dropping the leg across the ballsackial region of Stone Cold. Oh, and a nice counter into a backstabber. Edge running all the way over there just to get headbutted in the face.
Oh,
I don't know how the hell Austin wound up going toward the ring on that one, but alright.
Onto the apron.
No counter this time as Edge drills him with those big uppercuts. Going for a cover now. Only a one count for Edge. The champ still with the advantage. Austin going back to that weaponry, bringing them out in the ring with Edge. Knocking him down and stealing it. Austin paying for bringing that foreign object in here. Austin is literally and figuratively on the ropes at this time. Not a strong showing so far. Oh, maybe I spoke too soon though. Oh, it's chucking Edge into the corner.
He's looking for a momentary respite, King.
All right, I can do that.
Well, there you go.
We gained a little bit of health.
You're feeling fine now.
Thank you for the chair.
Gets waylaid with these chair
shots. That's how the Rock must have felt at WrestleMania 17.
Here,
no,
oh no.
He just carries those in his pockets. Oh, running. It's kind of a running punch, I guess. Oh no! Edge looked to have everything in firm control, but just dove to the outside. Face first. Onto the floor. And Austin bringing the motorcycles, all of them left over from Undertaker's days as the American Badass. Oh no! The stunner on the floor! Edge is actually lucky that that happened on the floor. He'd been in the ring. Could have been the end of the match. Payback's a bitch, by God. Execution to Austin. He still have to get in the ring to finish off their opponent, though. Oh, Austin getting up just in the nick of time.
Here you go, into the ropes, over the ropes, come on!
And now going for the weapons again.
Oh, this should be fun.
Vintage Austin. Austin just got hammered. Austin got hammered, by God. And is that it? It is. The world champion Edge. Victorious in a non-title matchup. Taking out Stone Cold Steve Austin for the second time. Incredibly strong showing from the champ. That's what we like to see. And exactly 1 hour into the show. Well, that felt like it went by just so quickly. That about wraps things up tonight for Battlegrounds. I'm actually going to see, though, before we go, if there's anybody else streaming this game right now that might benefit from a raid of the small amount of viewers we have. Assuming you guys want to stick around for that, of course, it's your call. This is not another story. This is not another dream. Yeah, got a couple. Alright. I'm going to be back here tomorrow night. Oh, thank you, MVG. Hope you have a good night, too. Thanks for being here. I'm going to be back tomorrow night for MWF Mattitude. Me, Chris Coron, Red Jet, doing commentary on Fire Pro Wrestling World. And then next Tuesday from Matt Wars and WWE 2K19. And back here next Wednesday night for another edition of Battlegrounds. All those streams starting at 9 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Central. And, oops. I was trying to figure out how to raid. I'm kind of new to that. Alright, I think this should work. There's not enough people that play this game. Alright, apparently it doesn't want to let me do it. Well, that's embarrassing. Okay, sorry about that. Apparently it's not going to work. But anyway, like I said, be back tomorrow. Thanks for being here tonight. Hope you guys have a great evening. I'll catch you later.